Markets wild once again today. How long will this last? What's up, everybody? Welcome aboard to Bubba's Daily Update. It is Monday, the 19th of October, and, well, we're higher, but they were much higher. They went lower, and now they're coming back higher again. So the question is, how long does the craziness last? And, well, probably the answer is until after the election, at least. I mean, we're having, you know, different kinds of reports come all the time. Many were banking on this a stimulus package that probably not going to happen, and I hope it doesn't. In the meantime, we're still long. Markets are up. So again, we'll follow the price action. It'll be what it is, and there's no thought or negotiation with my opinion based on what's going on. It's all about the price action. It's all about the algorithm. It's that simple. The metals were much better. I'm higher. So, you know, it's not much, but, you know, about 10 bucks higher in gold and so forth. Reverse down, turn negative. Now they're back close to unchanged, maybe slightly higher again. But again, gold reached and platinum, gold, silver, and platinum all reached a resistance level, failed. We're still short. We'll remain there again until it is dictated to change. The dollar is under pressure, which we're short. Net gas, copper, higher. We're long both. Crude oil is now higher. We are still long. Bonds and notes are getting cracked, and we're still short. So again, pretty much on the right side of markets. Now again, they can change at any moment, but right now, as I'm reporting, that's where we are. And, you know, again, I won't, I don't try to finagle numbers. They are what they are. They're straight up. Grains were up very nicely early and suddenly have started to come under some pressure. Corn is now slightly lower, wheat is lower, and soybeans are slightly higher. But again, remember that when the market is strong, like the soybean, corn, and wheat markets are, sell-offs or dips are just buying opportunities. So we're just looking for opportunities to potentially add to our positions, not reverse them out yet. I mean, they're still very, very strong right here. The meats, on the other hand, are pretty much according to the way they're supposed to be acting based on where we stand. We reversed cattle this morning, live cattle. It's down. Feeder cattle is down, and hogs are almost up the limit once again. So again, you can see by just dictating and following price, that's what you need to do. That's where you have to understand, because at the end of the day, it's all about the price action. Again, forget about the news. Forget about the crap. It's straight up. It is in front of you. So don't try to outsmart the market. In the meantime, in the softs, cotton, we're still long. It's higher. OJ, we're long. It's higher. Coffee, we're short. It's lower. Sugar, we're long. It's higher. And cocoa is higher. We're shorted. So again, we'll see. Again, I don't watch those as actively because I don't trade them actively. So we'll see. I'll let you know what they are tomorrow. And in the meantime, don't forget our great partnership with Family Farms. Looking forward to go on the road, Iowa, Nebraska, and Kansas, and, you know, just under a month now. And I'm going to get some exact locations of where we're going to be, and we'll do some seminars in that place to get everybody on the right mode of learning how to hedge the crops as well as the equities, right? As long as you're investing, because your farm is your investment. So that's something that's very important, and I want to make sure you understand it. Our brokerage partners, now I do have other brokerage accounts, but our partners that we prefer, CTG for commodities and futures. Number one, they do a great job. Number two, they're the only authorized vendor of our signals, letter of direction. And number three, they're coming out with some brand new products, which I'm going to be fortunate enough to help them introduce on the second Saturday of November. And of course, Tradier, I mean, I go back to the same thing, 10 bucks a month, but 10 bucks a month plus automated trading, if you choose, that's up to you. But how can you pass that up? To me, it makes no sense logically. But hey, again, it's your money. You got to do what you think is right. Our commodity report, Andy Heck, Tectimental. You know, as I tell you all the time, Andy's a terrific, you know, 40-year veteran of really trading. Worked for the big banks, was the world traveler and the vice president of many of them, and actually trading physicals as well. Writes a great report. Comes out weekly, and then a monster report every quarter. but he also gives you a spreadsheet of all the things that he's tracking and how he sees them. So again, and we are doing a webinar the first Saturday of November, Andy and I, and of course, we're going to change it so the prices are going up. You can lock in today or between now and that first Saturday at the price on the board, but it will be going higher because we're going to make some dramatic changes to make it even better than it already is. And of course, don't forget our high school program at Patreon, patreon.com/BubbaTrading. That's patreon.com/BubbaTrading. In the meantime, go Niners, money line and plus a spread. What an easy victory. All right. And in the meantime, we've got two games tonight, Buffalo and Kansas City. Tough game. You would think Kansas City would bounce back. A small pizza and a beer on the Bills tonight, just plus the points, 5.5. And the Dallas-Arizona game, the marquee game, look, I don't know. I didn't think Arizona should have been favorite in the first place. And now Dallas is the favorite, but we're still taking Dallas and laying the 1 point because I think that they're going to, as they say, schmatter them. In the meantime, have a great day, everybody. This is Bubba's Daily Update. We'll see you back here on Tuesday. Hopefully my voice will be back to normal. In the meantime, have a great day. Be careful. Discipline and patience always win the day.